Hey, how's it going, guys? This is Eckyman, and welcome back to another episode of our playthrough of Project Zomboid. Okay, so lots to do today. We're going to start fortifying our base. So, first thing I need to do is start chopping down some trees, and I think we'll go for these ones as they are closer. I probably should think twice about speeding it up while I do this. But, eh, we're living dangerously. We've got a tree branch here as well, so what I'm going to do is try and remember how to make stone axe, rip sheets, twine, chipstone, tree branch. Okay. Two chipstones there. We got any rip sheets? Yeah. So we're going to make a couple of backup axes. Well, we're going to make a couple of axes for chopping trees. I don't want to waste my fire axe on this. Two tree branches. And then if we go to that. Craft all. Alright. So, I can close that. And now I have a raw axe. Cut that in both hands. And now we're not wasting our fire axe. I can use that for zombie killing. It takes a bit longer to chop a tree down. And they break pretty easily. But I think it's worth it. Whoops. So I'm just going to chop a few trees down here. And there goes the first one, I think. Yep, broken raw axe, so we'll equip this in both hands. We've got as much as we can with these two axes. We can always forage for more chipped stones as well, because now we're chopping down trees, we've got access to the branches. Alright, they've both broken. Can I forage somewhere? There we go. Oh, one other thing I want to do as well is put my... did I get anything? No. We're going to put in the doodads. Can I repair these? No. We're going to put in the fishing net. Let's move this stuff over. Put some stuff in here as well, yeah. Sounded like a dog, that was weird. So we'll get that. I won't bother with the fishing rod just yet, but we do have that option available to us. Okay, and I'm going to take a quick rest, get rid of this exertion. Well, that was a gunshot, nice. So we might have some zombies around this area soon. There we go. Alright, well, it's raining. That's fine, I've got time to get down there and put my net down. Probably going to make a corridor along here at some point, maybe off camera. But just basically so we can get to this area easier. So I'll put it there. Yeah. How much water have we got left? Yeah, we're doing okay. Right, so now I need my hammer, nails, and saw. Well, that's a point as well. I should make some traps, put them around the tree line. And then we've got food coming in, even if we don't actually have a farm up and running just yet. Wow, that is loud. Alright, well, one hammer, some nails, and a saw. I've got a tent peg. Could do with a couple of those, and then I could make a tent. tent. Now this is where my slow inventory transfer trait is really going to hit me the hardest, is moving logs over. Okay. I'm going to saw all these inside the house so we don't get drenched. And while we're doing that, oh, I can put a point in nimble, so I will do that. Of course, we have the XP boost for carpentry. So that's good. Yeah, we're getting quite a lot just for sawing stuff up. Anyway, let's get barricading. So I'll fully do all the windows and then probably create a wall around this place. And I'm thinking of doing a wall further down as well, right across the entire area. So if any zombies have to come at us, they come through the trees. That'll slow them down a bit at least. Alright, so we should be able to fully barricade this up with what we have. But I need to get out of this, out of the rain. Alright. So we're done. We still have... No, we have no wood left. That's fine. Has it just stopped raining? I mean, the sound's still there, but... I don't see the graphic. Let me just pop inside for 2 seconds. I'm going to grab a drink of coffee here while I've got a moment. There we go. So, let's go and take a look at what I'm talking about. Oh, actually... Alright, well, we might just wall off across here then, I guess. Well, first of all, let's make an area around our house. I think. How are we going to do this? I want 2 layers. I want a wall around here. And then a separate area here with a door and a door. So any zombies have to come through 2 doors and we can... Well, I'll do something similar at the back as well. And then I've got escape routes. Well, let's just start putting a wall around this place for now. I want to make it a decent sized area so that I can... put a farm in here as well. Wait, what? I have carpentry. Level 1. That's weird. Oh, I need carpentry level 2 to make walls. Really, that's a new change. Okay, well, let's put these planks on the floor. I'll saw up a few more logs. We should be able to get it as soon as I have that multiplier going. There we go. So I put my point in carpentry. Now I need the... Let me see, have I got the book for level 3? Because there's no point building anything if we don't have... if we're not getting the XP boost. We've got to try and make the most out of everything we have here. Even though I do have fast learner on, so I'm actually learning at an increased rate anyway, but still... So, that's the level 3 to 4. So I'm going to get that. And, yeah, just read it. I'm going to speed this right up, though. Which is going to make me get very tired, very hungry, and very bored and unhappy, probably. And there's the hunger. There's the bored. And there's the thirsty. Alright, well, we got it learned. And it really didn't take too long. Let's get some sleep. I'll drink some coffee. I think I have a magazine I can read, so... Actually, I'm hungry as well, so let's have a look for some chocolate. Because that's going to do both my moodles here. Put my book back on the... Right, these are all the ones I've read. Okay, so we can start putting up some walling now. 38 nails. Let me grab a box of nails real quick. Wow, I've got a lot. That's good. What I'll do is I'll build some of it in this episode, but then I might do a load between episodes. Just so we've got a slightly faster process going on here. Okay. So, we're going to put our wall like here, I think. And we'll go this way with it first. Okay. Also going to have to do some more foraging as well, because I really don't want to waste the durability of this axe. I know I can repair it, actually, so it's not too bad. So I want a good few tiles between the back of the house and the back of the fence. I don't want to be too enclosed. Okay. Is that a chipped stone? Nope, it's nothing. A bit more foraging. Am I getting any points in foraging? I'm getting some. Stone, but not a chipped stone. I can't make it a chipped stone by like hitting it, can I? No. Okay. Okay. Chips, chips, chips. Oh, I should go and check our doodad as well. Our doodad. fishing net. Let's go take a look over there. I'm going to make a campfire kit so we can cook this stuff up, and also, I don't know if I've got a cooking pot, but I should start stockpiling the water soon as well. So we're not going to need rain collector barrels, because we can just come here. I've got 5 little bait fish out of that, that's good. Right, so we can cook those up. That's a bit of food for us. How long have we been surviving? Do we have 19 days? We might not have electricity anymore. I can check that out now, though. I'm not too worried if we don't. Alright, so... Oh, I've got no turn-on option. So, yeah, we don't have that. Let's go and... I want to take all the logs first. Right, make a campfire kit. Which is there. And other thing I want to do is make a couple of sturdy sticks. Let me look at my trapping, survivalist, where's my trapping info? Huh. Alright, well, I need some string, I think. Or twine. Forgetting exactly what I need to make traps now. I don't want to make a splint, no. Twine, twine. Is that what I need? Huh. Don't need a screwdriver, do I? I've forgotten entirely what I need to make trap. One second. I can look this up. I thought all I needed was the sticks and twigs. Let me just Google this real quick. Zomboid traps. Trap. Saw, plank, and nails. Sturdy stick and twine. Yeah, I've got all that stuff available, so why can't I... Why can't I make a trap? Well, that's weird. Okay, well, we're not doing that then. I'm looking at it here, then. I just need a saw, 3 planks, and 5 nails. No crafting level required. That is so weird. Trapping level 1 for a snare trap. Okay, well, we're not doing that then. Yeah, it's not in there either. Alright, I'm not going to worry about it now. I'll look that up afterwards and find out what I was doing wrong. So, we'll keep building for a bit. Or, that'll be it as it happens. Right, well, I need more chipped stones. And I guess we can build a fire. Let's put it right here. It's far enough away from stuff that it shouldn't burn my house down. Add fuel. I don't want to add sturdy sticks, so what I'll do is I'll rip these sheets. Remove these bodies as well. Has the rain washed the blood away? I think it might have done, you know. That's awesome if it has. Rip sheets, yeah. Okay. Oh, I need a lighter as well. Which I should have in here. Huh. Now I've got one. Lighter. There we go. And it would start raining. Okay. Rip sheets and lighter. Let's add a bit more fuel to it. Oops. Ah, of course, the rain's just going to put it out. Alright, well, I'm not going to worry about that then. I guess I will call this the end of the episode here, actually. And what I'll do is I will forage a little bit off camera. And hopefully get some more chipped stones so we can continue making axes. Save the durability on this one. But yeah, I'm going to call this the end of the episode here, guys. So, as always, really hope you've enjoyed watching this. I'm out for now, and I will see you soon for some more Project Zomboid. Peace.